Hi, my name is Sumukhi Suresh. If you guys are like, we know that already. It's okay, I'm saying it again. We, Shefali, are waiting for you. All about the look, but I'm super excited about the jewelry too. If you could give me the details for me to buy all of it.
Buy or no? Steal?
Okay, oh, okay. Yes, congratulations, second nomination.
We are two comedians at the International Emmys.
Yeah.
Which means we are both terrified.
Yeah, exactly. You can cut it now. Hi.
Hello.
Good evening.
Hello.
I like how all three of us live in Bombay, but we've decided to meet in New York.
Yeah.
So fancy.
Where do you live in Bombay?
I live in Bandra now.
Where do you live in Bombay?
Lokhandwala.
I live in Bandra. But this is South Bombay, baby.
That's correct. No, the thing about nomination, I'm wondering, because of course you're supposed to say you're feeling great, amazing, yes. But from the time you found out that you've been nominated till now, tell me the myriad of emotions, the range of emotions.
It didn't sink in. I don't think it's still sunk in.
Yeah.
I'm just going with the flow. I remember Neha calling me and telling me about the nomination. Really? You're sure? And she's like, why are you so surprised?
Yeah, how can you be so surprised?
But I was. And then after some time, I was like, acha, now next? Ab next kya kare? Matlab not next, like kya achieve kare, but like next, matlab acha, wo moment excitement ho gaya, abhi next excitement ka kya
kare? Nice. Like,
and I got here and I have to say, I've thoroughly enjoyed the last 3 days. You know, I realized that the consolation prize hota hai na. I used to feel it's to console. The logical meaning is sorry, beta. Lekin tum aaye to sahi, ye rakho. Hai na? But I don't feel like that about this. I feel it's almost as
because
you won.
You are.
All of y'all are here together.
You're one of 40 people from
the world.
Thousands and thousands
true.
Of people
true.
In the world. Yeah. When I thought of this special, there was a debate that was happening between me and Netflix. Do we shoot it this year or do we shoot it next year? And I was very passionate about this special. So I called up somebody at Netflix and I was like, let's go shoot this show and get nominated for an Emmy together.
Oh right?
And I just said it because I was passionate in that moment. I would never, you know, say something like that out loud. Akash, who co-produced the special with me, we got nominated once before.
Yeah.
And I was just exercising in the house and I saw that he had framed his old medal and his old certificate. And I was like, tune kya kya? Diwal pe lagaya. He's like, I'm like, mera bhi frame kar de yaar. He's like, aap leke aao. I went to the other room, I opened up the drawer, I took my certificate and my old medal out, I dropped them on Akash's table, and 30 seconds later, I was nominated for another Emmy Award. So
amazing.
So, ye jo Joey jeeta wahi Sikandar wali moment aayi hai abhi. This is such a good moment.
I'm just going to keep calling Tanya and being like, I'm going to win $1 million.
And like make, oh, it's like the Chandler scene. It's like, I'm $1 million.
And just keep having Akash hold things that I want from the world.
This is wonderful. But tell me about, specifically about landing. I know you've gotten a nomination before.
Yes.
But what about landing that you're like, yeah, you know, I'm glad that it made it to this point.
It's a weird thing, but I think the universe gave me a retry. In that, the last time I was here at the Emmys, I didn't really enjoy it. And I was mentally absent completely, because I was in some trouble, right? And so it was the same week. And so I just kind of walked through the Emmys in sort of a mental daze. And this whole thing was like the universe going, all right, that was a tough week. We're going to give you one chance just to enjoy it again, you know? So. What I told my wife and everybody here is like, I'm going to drink every drink. You know, I'm going to put on the shiny ass jacket. I'm going to enjoy, win or lose, I am here again to enjoy this and this is the win.
Yeah.
You know, the universe literally brought me, like, I had something tough happen to me at the Emmys. I wrote a show about it and it brought me back to the Emmys. So it's the completion of
it's
a
like
story.
A, yeah, oh, you amazing. Finished the hero's journey. That's what it was. The same, because your character range has been... It's fabulous. So I don't want to go on again. And then I just saw, I seem like a fine girl, which I am. But was there a particular, not a character also, was just a moment or a meeting or just a conversation where you're like, no, I'm in this. Because when I look at you, I feel like you're going to be acting till you are there. And that's
you could have said till you die as well.
No, I don't say that. I get very
we're all
going
to die, guys.
No, I'm not existing at all. But
after 19 Emmys. Shefali will move on to the
and seven
Gabi
Oscars.
Woo!
Yeah, and a couple of national awards.
Nice, yeah. I mean,
perfect.
Yeah, why not? Yeah, but was there like a point where you're like, no, this is forever. This is not going to stop. And especially because actors end up stopping na at some point. And they're like, hame to koi pasand nahi karta. And then we all sulk in our little corners.
Every day. Matlab, when my career has been more about waiting than actually working. Also, ek kuch kiya, fir do saal, they think I'm dead or something. Then I come back. You know, it's like that. Achha, oh, nahin mari. Oh, sorry, sir. She's still there.
You're like Karwa Chauth.
Totally.
Oh, she's dekho chanda hai.
It's like that. It's like that. So, every time I feel ki ye chhod do, ab is ye nahi hoga beta, tumko nahi milenge roles. It's not going to happen. To tum chalo, backpack karke nikal padho. And then something comes which excites me. But I don't want to say no. You know what I mean? I was pained, I was depressed, I was demotivated. But I just still wanted to be, acha theek hai na, nahi milta hai, lekin mujhe karna hai.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? At least in my mind, I can dream about it, yeah. To sahi na. Ho nahi ho, alag baat hai.
Yeah.
So I never really, I don't know what I would do if I didn't do what I do. I love what I do. I love it. I'm the happiest on set.
Isn't there that old saying, I think, some people say it's Greta Garbo, some people say it's Marilyn Monroe, whatever, but it's, I act for free, you pay me to wait.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Which is a great saying about
that. Yeah. So like, cool.
The acting's free.
So naturally at it. So tell me more about that.
I think, and this is something that you and I understand, comedians or funny people need to multitask. We need to write, we need to create. Because we create content that doesn't have ego. Right?
Oh, yeah,
When a big star casts themselves at the center of something that is to do with glamour, building up, hero's journey, when we write a script for ourselves, it is how much can I suffer in this role? How much can I beat myself down in this role? How much can I embarrass myself? Yeah. So nobody knows how to use a funny person's voice better than a funny person.
Yeah.
I know what to do with you and you know what to do with me.
Yeah.
Because we're both funny. So you understand that I can't put Veer in a ganji and make him do some this thing. I have to have something run into Veer and have him drop. You know?
Nice, yeah,
so
true.
I think that's why it's really important for funny people to direct, to act, to create, because I don't think you can expect mainstream directors to know how to capitalize on what we have.
Yeah. Do you feel like, are you going through an imposter syndrome on stage? Or are you finally like, no, I'm closest to my voice?
Oh, I don't think I'm good enough at the end of each day. Like, I think there's an opportunity if I put in 10 years of really hard work. I'm in the sweet spot where, you know, comedians, when they hit 50 is where that...
It starts.
They just pop, right?
Up, yeah,
they become Chris Rock, they become Dave Chappelle,
etc.
I've got 10 years, right, in that neighborhood where I'm like, if I put in a decade of really hard work, I can be somebody who's somebody to contend with in this art form.
Yeah.
You know, so that, I just want to get really good at this.
I'd ask you guys, can you just nominate two other people if they would have been nominated for an international Emmy at any given point? Like, even if your own character, like, should it be Shamshu or should it be some other special of yours?
Yeah.
Should it just be in your first 5 minutes? I think Shamshu though.
I would love Shamshu. I also think Vartika from season one.
Yeah? Yeah, actually.
And
she set the tone. Yeah.
Yeah, she definitely set the tone.
She set the tone for the show, for the whole, like, the fact that it could have easily just been that a limited series, but she made sure that now it's going to go on till when, you know, forever.
I wish there were international Emmys, or maybe there were, I'm not sure, when Delhi Belly was released.
I
feel like that comedy category,
oh my God.
We had a good place in. And stand-up wise, I think what I'm writing next.
Yeah?
I hope the world will enjoy it.
Okay, I'm winning the internship. Both of you are giving me tips for winning speech. So now we're not jinxing anything, but we're talking about winning speeches.
Okay.
When
Sumukhi wins an International Emmy Award, I would say wear comfortable shoes. Because you have to run up to the stage, right?
Oh, yeah.
So you got to get there quick.
Oh, wow, right? Yes.
So wear something that you can run in. Try and get your crying done on the way up.
Okay.
And then on the way back, because nobody likes it, you know, like on the mic.
Yeah. So the subtle crying, the itna wala,
just let it drop.
Tap.
Yeah. Just, okay, cool. Okay.
Like
okay.
One close up and one boom.
Yeah, one boom.
Like Amir Khan and Rangdev Basanti when he's eating the roti. One,
what?
The pack onto the medal. And then just.
Oh my God.
And if you high speed, aisa boom. Ah,
God. Thank you so much, you guys. I would invite you now inside so that you're not frozen cold.
Yes, my nipples could cut glass right now. Profound conversation about death and acting. We just comes in, he's like, my nipples could cut glass right now. That's it. I just need one laugh. I'm a comic.
All right. We need another end.
Yes. My shoes are from Hill Road. That's crazy. And my attitude is from a lot of baggage.